thought we'd start out with a little music every week and change things up, not always have just a quiet session until we get started. Welcome, everyone, today. My name's Kevin Vogel. I'm going to be your host. And welcome to our Together Tuesday. Today, you're going to see with me, I have both Melissa. Hi, Melissa.
Hey, Kevin.
And Abby. And Abby's got a new picture this week. Look at that.
Yeah. Hey, we might need to update that one.
Well, that's because, what do you mean you look fantastic? But no one will know you're an Arkansas fan anymore.
I know.
All right. So one thing that I did want to show everyone to, let me just share my screen instead of the presentation here. Just one second here. And I'll show people because some people commented, oh, this must be a new feature inside of Teams. And it's really not. If you're doing a presentation like I'm doing here, one of the things you can do to enable your system sound is when you go to share your screen, up at the top right-hand corner, it says enable system sound. If you forget it, all you got to do is scroll all the way up to the top of your screen, and this little box right here says include, what does it say, include computer sound. That way, anything, like if you have a video hidden inside a PowerPoint presentation, you want to play music at the beginning of your meeting, anything like that that you can hear through your system speakers, you'll now be able to hear through Teams. And this has been here for quite a while, so it's not new. It's just I figured, you know, we usually get on 5 minutes early. I look for a song that I like. That's about 5 minutes long, and I try to put that on, you know, so that anyone that joins can do that. So I hope that little hint helps you guys. I think it's pretty cool. So here's what we're going to do. So I got a couple of more tips, five different tips that you can use with Office 365 and Teams. And these are things that I do all the time. I always get questions about it, so we figured we'd throw it in here. And then we're going to talk about Microsoft Compliance Manager. And for those of you that don't know about this, this is a product from Microsoft, especially if you're in an industry where compliance is really, really important. This is something you might want to take a look at. So I figured I'd throw it in there. So first of all, we're going to talk about, I don't know if you see this, but I have the lobby set up for these Together Tuesdays. But I could turn that off. I could show you how to do that. I can restrict who can present inside of a meeting. I can, you know, show you how you can mute the audience prior to the meeting. All these things are in there. And I'm going to show you how you can see different versions of the same file inside of Teams. And then some of the newer updates, you know, that Teams is coming out with. So just figured I'd throw these in here. So let's go over here to my Teams client. Hold on. I got to find the right one. And we're here. So as you can see, I'm in a calendar here. And if I go into any of my meetings that I set up or any of the webinars that I set up or even live events, there is a options tab inside of each one of these. Now, if I take a look at a meeting that's already started like we have here, if I go up to the three dots here, and I go down here to meeting options. This is where you'll be able to control things. And you can do it after you start the meeting, before you start the meeting, whatever you want to do. But right here, you can go in and say who can bypass the lobby. So normally, by default, at least it is in our organization, is people in my organization and trusted organizations and guests. That's the default setting, but you can make it just your organization, the people I invite, you know, and then turned off forwarding. I can do it that way. I can only let me join the meeting without going to the lobby, or I can set it to everyone. So usually when I start the meeting, when I see the first one, like Caleb was the first one in the meeting today, I went in and changed this to everyone so that you're bypassed the meeting. So you can go in there and change that. Any setting that you change here, you do have to hit the save button for it to take effect. So just to let you know. So one of the things I talked about was who can talk. So if you want to allow the mics for attendees, it's right there. If you want to turn them off, if you don't want your attendees to be able to use their mic, just hit the allow attendees and click. Now, if you have people that are presenters in this meeting, they'll be able to present and talk and all that stuff. A camera is the same way. If I wanted to turn off anyone that has a camera, I can do that right here. I can also set this to start recording automatically. But that means when I start the meeting, and sometimes, you know, we get on here 5 minutes early. I don't want the recording to just have 5 minutes of pretty much dead air at the beginning of the meeting. So I usually leave that one off and just, you know, try to remember to hit the record button when we're doing this. The other thing is who can present. So if you're looking for who can present in here, you can make specific people. So if I just wanted to allow, for instance, we'll go in here, and I only wanted Melissa to be able to present, or I wanted even someone from an external location in here, like Jeff or Pedro, I could go in here and enable those people to present also. So pretty easy to go in here and change that. I usually leave it at everyone, but, you know, because you never know who's going to want to show something. I can also disable the meeting chat. I could also go in here and disable any of the reactions, you know, the claps, the thumbs ups, you know, all those type of things. Once you change the settings here, you're good to go. Just hit save, and that will save whatever you've done in here. The other place that you can do it, and this is the place that I usually do it, is I usually set up my meetings here in Outlook. You know, it's what I've done forever. And if I go in here, let's say that I want to set up a meeting here on Friday at 9 o'clock, and I hit new Teams meeting, you'll see that meeting options come up right away. So I could go in here. This is kind of small, so you might not be able to see it, but come on. But I can go in here and do exactly what you saw before, just smaller type for some reason. They like to keep these small. But all the settings that you saw in there before, you can go in here and change, hit the save button, and those settings will be saved for that meeting. Pretty quick, pretty easy. And now you can go in and go ahead and schedule your Teams meeting. Obviously, it puts in all the information. If you have audio conferencing, which as you guys probably know, audio conferencing starting in March will come free with every enterprise, business premium, or business standard license that Microsoft has, and that starts in March. So you'll be able to assign a phone number inside of each one of your meetings that, you know, people can dial in with. There is unlimited minutes, so you don't have to worry about, you know, going over the limit. You can also, once you get those things, you can even go in here, and if you want someone to join a meeting by dialing their cell phone, you can go in here and just plug in their number right up here, call them unlimited minutes, and have them join the meeting with their cell phone, with their, you know, local phone from home or whatever you want. So right up here, real easy to do it. So wanted to throw in just some of those features that you might not know about. Let's see if there's any questions in here. Nope. Okay. And Brooke asked, if you're playing a song like that and you turn on transcription here, when you turn on your recording, does it know the lyrics? Will it actually copy down the lyrics? I don't know. I've never looked, but, you know, maybe I'll look after this and see if it did. So just want to let you know those things. All right. So just figured I'd throw in some things inside of Office that you've probably never seen before. So Office Compliance Manager. And like I said, this is something that Microsoft offers. You can go in there, and this is a great way to get compliant, stay compliant, and also scale compliancy across your whole environment. It's got really intuitive management. I'm going to show you a quick demo. I am not a compliance guy. I'm not a security guy, but you'll be able to see it's pretty easy to do. It's scalable. So you could take advantage of ready to use customized templates that are in there. And I'll show you those when we go into the demo. It's got built-in compatibilities. It will give you your score, your control mapping, versioning, and things like that. Oh, I forgot to show you how to get different versions in Teams. Hold on. I forgot something that I was going to show you. So if I go in here, I'm going to show you this. Let's say I go into our Teams here, and let's just say I go into this Teams practice here, which I know we got a whole bunch of files with changes in here. So if I scroll down, and let's just say I pick one of these documents here, and I'm going to try to find one that I know has multiple versions. Shoot, where is our, I know this one does right here. So if I go in here and I open this up in SharePoint, you can't do it directly from Teams, but you can absolutely do it in SharePoint. So if you go in here, yeah, of course, it's going to ask. We do multi-factor and all that stuff. So if I go in here now and I take a look at that one in here, I can go in and look at version history. And you're going to see that there are four different versions of this same presentation. That means that, well, I went in here or the SharePoint app went in here and made changes. So if I don't want the latest version, the one that the last change was on 5.13. Let's say I want the one that was back at the beginning of or the end of 2020. I could actually click on this and open that old version of that presentation or any document that we're sharing in Teams, which backends is SharePoint. I can open that version of that document so I can get rid of all the changes that happen and look at the original presentation. So great tool that I use all the time, especially because we share a lot of files. So, you know, somebody might make a change in a presentation that I don't like. So I go back and go to my original version. I can then save it as a different name, put my name next to it or something, and that way I have that version to work with. So just a little FYI. Sorry, I forgot to show you that. I got a little ahead of myself. So let's talk about the security, the compliance manager here. You're going to see that there's over 320 ready to use, but also customizable regulatory assessment templates that are built into this environment. So you can go in and pick one specifically for your industry, specifically for your needs case, and they're already in there. And then you can tweak them a little bit to make them work just for you. In here, like you heard in the upfront, you can get your compliancy score. You can see what you're doing well, what you're not doing well. You can drill into each one of these areas and really get a good look and feel at your environment. You can also go in here and review different frameworks for different environments. So if you have an Office 365 environment, an Azure environment, a Dynamics environment, you can go in here and see the controls that you have around each one of those. Pretty simple, pretty easy to use. You can also look at different groups inside of your environment. So if you set up, you know, groups with your teams that you want to look for compliancy, especially if you're sharing documents outside of your environment, great tool to be able to make sure that you're not sharing any information that you shouldn't be sharing. So if, for instance, GDPR, if you're over in Europe and, you know, you got to make sure that you're compliant with GDPR. If you're ISO like 27001 and, you know, any of these type of things, you can go in here and see if those teams, if those groups are compliant. This runs $12 a month. It is an annual subscription. There is a free trial. You can actually open this up, run it for, you know, 30 days and see if this is something that, you know, you see the value in for your corporation. So, like I said, there are a lot of safeguards behind this. And let me just show you it live. So I'll show you. I got it running right here. Oops, wrong one. I know I have it. There it is. Okay, so with here, this is the compliance manager. And again, you could see I'm logging in with my credentials. There's, you know, no difference. This is pass-through authentication. You can give certain people administration rights. You can give them the right to view like the reports that are in here or any of your scores that you want to do. So you can see your compliance score. Ours is 75%. This happens to be a demo account that I'm using, but I can go right in here and visit compliance manager right from here. I could also click here. But this will actually draw up a more detailed score that so you can make those changes to increase your scores. Come on, just give it a second. It's you can see it a live demo. It's actually pulling information live. Okay, so here's where I could go in and grab any of these templates that we talked about. Here's the ISO 2701. Here's some premium templates for here's Kansas, here's Australia. You could see all different types in here. There's hundreds of them. There might even be thousands of them for different states, countries, things like that, that you can actually go in and use for either Office 365, Universal. These are templates for, you know, across your whole environment. You can get data connectors in here that will actually allow you. I don't have any connectors loaded in here, but if you want to, you know, connect to a SQL database and different things like that, you can go right in here. If you use Slack, WhatsApp app, Instant Bloomberg, and 60 more different, you can see them all in here. You can scroll down and take a look. They're all right here, pretty easy to use. You can go in and get reports. So you can, you know, schedule these. I don't have the permissions to go in and get these, but you can view all the details in here. It just takes you to all the prereqs that you need. I don't, like I said, I don't have permissions. Again, you can do all those type of things. The catalog right here. So data loss prevention, if you're looking at information governance, all these are right here for you to just take. You can go into privacy, inside risk management, discovery and response. All of it is part of this. It's a full catalog and you can go in and play with this. It's very easy. Just go to compliance.microsoft.com, sign in with your credentials. You can get that free 30-day trial that I was talking about and really start to just play with it. It's really something that you can use right out of the box. If you're looking for communication compliance, shoot, of course, I don't have it. But you can go in here and set up how you want to communicate with customers, what information you can actually put inside of an email, put inside of a text message, really a chat. I'm sorry, I said text message. You know, what you can post in a team that's actually shared externally, things like that. So all of that communication compliance can be right in here. Insider risk management, you can take advantage of, you know, who has permissions to what. Again, I don't have full permissions, but this is enough to show you. So you can see all these things are available to you. They work right out of the box. And all you need to do is go in. And like I said, just go to that compliance.microsoft.com. You'll log in with your credentials, sign up for the free trial, and it works just right out of the box. Let me just double check, see if there's any questions. Any questions come along here, Melissa?
No, I don't see anything currently in the chat window, Kev.
Okay, thanks. Just figured I'd check this out. We do have two more Together Tuesdays this month, one on February 15th, and we're going to review identity and access management for Office 365. And then we're going to bring in a couple of our support engineers, and we're going to basically pick their brains on some of the reports you could, that you can use, some of the things that they're hearing from, you know, the support desk, just to keep you guys up to what's new, what's happening inside the support area. And then on the 22nd, we're going to have the new updates to Inkscape platform. And this is, I think this is going to blow you guys away. It's related to the Microsoft CSP program. We're also going to do a full demo on the new Commerce Experience, or NCE, and all the changes that are there. So really pretty cool stuff. Sorry, I'm losing my voice here. And then we do have a webinar coming up, Unlocking the Power of Microsoft Security. We're going to be talking about managed security offerings that we have, and that's on the 23rd at 2 o'clock. So any of these things you can register for at messageops.com/events. Hold on one sec. Sorry about that, losing my voice. I've been talking all morning. With that, I don't have anything else. If you guys have any questions, anything you want to ask while we're on here for another 9 minutes, I'd be more than happy to answer. Nothing? Okay. All right, well, thank you for your time. I'll give you back 9 minutes in your day. I got through this quicker than I thought I would. But please ask us, get a hold of Melissa, get a hold of Abby, get a hold of me if you want, and let us help you out any way we can. You guys have a great day. See you next week.
Thank you, Kevin. Thank you, everybody.